Alright, welcome back to the channel. Today is a review of the Oppressor Mark II, which, I've been grinding this game out a lot. I've really been grinding. But anyway, I'm going to skip all that good stuff and just tell you up front about the Oppressor Mark II. Should you buy it? Should you skip it? What should you do? Pretty much, I'm just going to say buy it. I'm going to straight up, no biases in there. Buy it. Like, even though this is one of my favorite vehicles in GTA, and I'm willing to grind for it, this is the second vehicle I've grinded for, the first being the Hydra, and this being the second, which, I'm just gonna say this up front, the terabytes is needed for the trade price, which most of you probably know that from different GTA YouTubers that say stuff like that. They'll bring in leaks of what modders brought into the game and all that and can tell you. But yeah, you'll need the terabyte to get the trade price on the Oppressor. I would recommend getting that trade price because the terabyte is actually a moneymaker. Trust me on that. And it's easy. Solo. You get the Oppressor Mark II mixed in with the terabyte doing the missions I'm doing right now on screen and mix it in with Headhunter and Sightseer with the Securo Server VIP work, you're good. You're gonna be making $52,000 in a matter of like 7 minutes, dude. Like, I'm just telling you now, these missions are easy. You get a shit ton of XP and money. It's worth it, man. Just do it. But there are flaws with the Oppressor, I will say that. The first one being the boost. Oh my gosh. I will say, the way they set the boost up, I don't know if I'm utilizing it the right way or they just don't want you to use the boost at all. But the way I use the boost, as you're about to see in the gameplay, I use it when I get in like sticky situations of being close to low health or I'm just getting shot up to hell. I pretty much just use it to get out quickly, like as you'll see on the gameplay right here. I just use it like that. That's the only time I really use boost or I need to catch up to someone. That's really the only two times I use it. The other flaw is coming back to the ground. So pretty much this vehicle, you have to, when you're coming back to the ground, you kind of pump the gas a little bit when you're going down. You gotta like press it, then stop, let it fall a little bit, press it a little more, and it just, as you bring some momentum in with it, like, I know that sounds weird, but the more momentum you have and then it stops, it'll like just slow down more. But if you just get right on top where you want to land, you'll have to slowly just fall down to it. So I would recommend coming up on a target where you know you're going to be wanting to land, just pump the gas, like just point your Oppressor down a little bit at an angle and just kind of pump it a little bit, you know. And the last but not least of the flaws is you can only have one weapon equipped at a time. And what I mean is you either have a combat MG, well, I think it's just called an MG. I don't know what they call it, but it's like the cannons on the Buzzard and Annihilator. They don't really do much damage at all. Then you got the explosives MGs, which they're a little bit weaker than like the Savage and the Hydras. I think it takes like 3 to 4 hits to them on impact to kill a target. And then the third one is the homing rockets and the non-homing rockets, which those two are synced together, which I'm so glad for. And what goes along with this flaw is, if you equip one and you pay for it, the other one you had equipped, you would have to repay for it and equip it again. And I want to just tell you this, the weapons independently from each other, they are not cheap. They are really not cheap. So just think about what you want. If you want to go in with cannons, good luck to you. You might get shot off of this thing because that's another flaw that I forgot to mention actually, was you are really out in the open, which I thought that one was pretty obvious, but some people wouldn't really think like that. Like, oh, I could just fly around and hit them with the cannons. The cannons are a precise aiming, like, weapon, I guess you would say. Like, you have to precisely tilt the oppressor down if your target's below you. You gotta keep it steady. It's even hard sometimes to shoot the rockets off, because if you move just a couple inches to the left or right, and your target is either left or right depending on where your target is and where you're moving to, you could lock on from the target to a different target, and that's not good. So you gotta really choose what you want. I'd personally say the rockets is your best bet, not only because they're convenient, but they're really useful. And there's also between 20 to 30 rockets, and then your outer rockets. You'll realize it when you're like using them, you're just spamming them off, and then you just kind of, you want to shoot another one off, and then none of them's coming, and then you just got to go back into your terabyte. Just kind of think of it like this, like your vehicle, when it gets damaged, just drive it into your garage, take the damage away. It's kind of like that, but with the rockets, it brings the rockets back full. But yeah, I'd say that'll wrap up the review though. Just, I recommend getting it. Yes, there are flaws. If you can learn how to work around the flaws, you'll be good. But I hope y'all liked the video. Y'all know what to do. I'll catch y'all later. Deuces.